Hello friends, welcome to EduTap and also welcome to today's session, which is on few important scientific names of some important crops. And friends, this is a part of the series that we have started for NABARD Grade A 2021. This is lecture number 11 today, and one of the easiest topics, but yes, quite confusing. Yes, so friends, if you are new to our channel, I request you to kindly subscribe to our YouTube channel so that whatever the sessions that we are conducting, that you can go through. And also friends, if you are new here, I request you to kindly join our Telegram channel so that whatever the daily dose of free content that we are providing, you can avail that and you can utilize them for your preparation as well, for your exam preparation. And then this is our results for the recently released NABARD Grade A 2020. And friends, interviews have been conducted with these toppers. You can visit our channel for their interview, so that whatever the strategies or preparation plan that they have been following, that you can also have a look at that, and if at all you can use it for your own preparation as well, that's really good. And so friends, with this we'll start our class today. Before that, let me say hello to the friends. Yes, good evening Sonali, Ketki. Yes, we have already started. I think weekly once I'm taking, and because there's various other subjects are there for that, we are taking as per the series, once in a week or something like that, agriculture especially. So good evening Vikas, good evening Amisha, hello Black Shadow. Yes Ravi Prakash, this is useful for your FCI AGM general agriculture, that is technical paper. And also this is useful for your this paper as well, general administration, wherein there is a topic agriculture. Yes, good evening Sangeeta, after so many days Sangeeta. Good evening Bhanu Prakash. Yes, hello Shivam. So friends, getting back to the session, I can see so many answers coming up here. Penicetum glaucum is the scientific name of which crop? Penicetum glaucum is the scientific name of, yes, most of you all are right. Yes, it is Bajra. Yes, Amol, Pranjali, Sangeeta, Ramesh, Madhushri, Amisha, yes, it is Bajra. So can anyone tell me the scientific name of sorghum? Okay, we'll do, okay Sangeeta, all the best. Don't worry Pranjali, there are so many opportunities that will come up. Maybe one door is closed because some other door will be opening for you better than that. So don't worry, keep preparing. Yes, sorghum bicolor. See, Bajra, it's also known as cattle millet, candle millet, spiked millet, pearl millet, and yes, its scientific name of Bajra is Penicetum glaucum. Origin of Bajra is Africa, family Gramineae, that is Poaceae. It's cross pollinated crop, protogyny. It is the condition that it induces by itself to avoid self pollination. And here highest quantity of minerals is found in Bajra among all the cereals. One important point here, wheat, the general triticum, actually it is not triticum, triticum. See, the general bread wheat, it's called Triticum aestivum. Sorghum, sorghum bicolor, rice, Oryza sativa, sunflower, Helianthus annuus. Can you tell me the other varieties or other species of wheat that are used, like pasta wheat or that cakes or bread, more softer wheat? There are majorly three species of wheat. One is Triticum aestivum, the other is Triticum durum, which is used generally for pasta making and others, and other is Triticum compactum. So now I'm getting an opportunity to give you so many scientific names. I'm trying to give you as many as possible in this. So friends, yes, this is all about the first question. Yes, durum wheat is Sangeeta. So moving on to our next question. Okay, groundnut is also called as poor man's cashew nut, and what is the scientific name of groundnut crop? Scientific name of groundnut. See friends, whenever there is any crop that comes up during, you know, while you are going through any current affairs, try to get their scientific name. Yes, Bharat, Pallavi, Sangeeta, Abhirami, Nilesh, Amol, Pranjali, Buntu, Uma Kishore, Madhushri. Yes. This is Arachis hypogea. What is Glycine Max? Can anyone tell? Glycine Max. We'll see all the scientific names, whatever that have been given in each of these questions. Glycine Max, it is soybean. Eleusine corcana. This is soybean. Eleusine corcana. This is finger millet. And it's also called commonly kodo. Tagetes minuta. Tagetes minuta is the wild marigold, which was in news recently because, you know, I think Himachal Pradesh government, they are trying to extract, you know, extractions from these wild marigold that are generally used in medicines. And the pot marigold that we generally, you know, grow in at our homes, it is calendula species. Yes, wild marigold, Tagetes. Helianthus annuus, it is sunflower. I forgot what is extracted from this wild marigold. I'm not able to get that word. We'll see. Can anyone tell me what is that extractions that is, you know, extracted from wild marigold that is used in medicines? Very recently it was in news. I'm not able to recollect that word actually. If not, no problem. Tomorrow I'll get that. I'll give you the answer. Yes, groundnut is also called as monkey nut, earth nut, peanut, Arachis hypogea. Origin of groundnut is Brazil. Family leguminosae, subfamily Papilionaceae. Self-pollinated and day neutral crop, and gynophore of, you know, groundnut is known as peg. See, once the pollination happens, slowly this grows into soil and they pierce into the soil. Carotene, I'm not able to get that. No, not lutein. Very recently I have read that. It's okay, tomorrow we'll do that. I'll definitely give you the answer that. So it grows into the soil and then the pod is formed there. After pollination this happens. Next, moving on to our next question. Black gram, which is used as nutritive food fodder and green manuring crop, is one of the important agronomic crop. What is the botanical name of black gram? Yes, colors also it is done, but Priya, for medicinal purpose, there is something that is extracted from that, and now they are doing it on large scale, especially in Himachal Pradesh. Government itself is investing money, training the farmers to go for this. It's okay, no worries. Tomorrow I'll give you the entire, you know, detail of that news. Okay, Manash ma'am, how important Kurukshetra magazine is for ARD? It is important. You know, there are various, you know, articles that are prepared by, you know, various authors from different walks of life. So, you know, there are few questions that are currently in vogue. So, yes, the articles are important. You might get few questions from that. Yes, Vigna Mungo. Yes, it is Vigna Mungo. Kazan is Kazan, anyone? This is red gram. Sizer and Arentinum, Bengal gram. Macrotyloma uniflorum, horse gram. Dolichos lab, that field bean which we generally use. So these are the various scientific, yes, PGNP, yes, it's also called as PGNP. Tuer, yes, see black gram, it's the urad or urad bean, botanical name Vigna Mungo. Origin, South Asia, family leguminosae, subfamily Papilionaceae, it's a self-pollinated crop. This, see, this is a black gram. The urad dal which we use, that. So, this is a plant of Vigna Mungo, that is urad bean. Yes, lab bean, or the generally it's called field bean. Okay friends, moving on to our next question. Corchorus capsularis, it is an important fiber crop in India. Its common name is Corchorus capsularis. Yeah Deepak, actually there is a lot of difference between agriculture economy and agriculture economics. But since they haven't given any, I know you must be asking the question because this is what that has been mentioned in the FCI notification. Economy, it's all about, you know, the statistics, how it is doing, what is the structure, all this rural economy, how agriculture economy works, all that. And agriculture economics is something different, that is all technical, how the economics as such it is dealt with. Not lot of, yes, but there is difference. That's the reason we have, you know, in our course provided both the contents regarding agriculture economy as well as agriculture economics. Yes Madhushri, wild marigold, they are used for essential oil extraction. We'll discuss about that tomorrow. Pakka, I have noted it down. So friends, yes, I'm getting the answer. Yes, most of you are saying yes, it's jute. What is the scientific name of Mesta? Anyone? Mesta, it is Hibiscus cannabinus. Desi cotton. Yes, somebody has given me. Yes. Gossypium arboreum. Yeah, subdarifa is also one variety and cannabinus is also there, and Gossypium arboreum and herbaceum both are desi cotton. American cotton, Gossypium barbadens, and this Mesta belongs to family Malvaceae. Can anyone tell me cotton belongs to which family? Yes, Hirsutum is also American cotton and Barbadens, both varieties. Mostly cultivated American cotton is Hirsutum, and mostly cultivated in Desi cotton is Gossypium arboreum. Yes, Malvaceae, this also belongs to Malvaceae cotton. And one more important vegetable that belongs to Malvaceae is okra. Can anyone tell me the scientific name of okra? It is Abelmoschus esculentus. See, they are so widely, you know, different, you know, few are from vegetable family, few from, you know, fiber rich, that is what they produce. No, all these are different, but they belong to same family. Just like we human beings have, you know, in a single family, we have, you know, people with, you know, many variations. Similarly is with the case with, you know, plants also. Yes, this is jute which we were talking about. natural fibers, one of the important natural fibers, you know, in India after cotton, family Malvaceae. 85% of the world's jute cultivation is concentrated in Ganges Delta, especially to, you know, West Bengal. And retting is a process that is used to extract fibers from these jute plants. Black shadow, yes, I'll try to, but I can't promise. No, Amisha, not all. NPK ratios, not all are important. But yes, few important crops like field crops like paddy, wheat, you can go through them once. Deepika, this is in a tough question, but I suggest you to go through at least the crop names that are in news, you know, which appear in current affairs. Otherwise, you know, going through all the scientific names and remembering them would be difficult. And mostly, you know, generally whatever that are in news, the tendency is that, you know, questions would be asked from that only generally. Okay, thank you, Pallavi. Gossypium barbadense has the longest fiber length. Right. Let's move on to our next question. Sugar beet is important sugar crop and it's a biennial crop. It's ontogenetically. Its scientific name is. Okay, I'm getting answers here. Beta vulgaris. Yes, you are right. Glycine max we have already seen. Soybean. Saccharum officinarum, sugarcane, Crotalaria junctia, it's a sun hemp, which again is a green manure crop. Beta vulgaris, yes, it is sugar beet. And this beta vulgaris, again, there's a variety Saccharifera. This is sugar beet and there is one more beetroot that also is beta vulgaris variety vulgaris. So little bit different here. Yes, Saccharum officinarum, it is sugarcane. Yes, biennial crop, family Amaranthaceae, and origin Mediterranean. Origin, it contains high concentration of sucrose and generally it is grown commercially for sugarcane production. So this is about the sugar beet, beta vulgaris, Saccharifera. And next, sorghum is a crop which can be grown with very less water. Botanical name of sorghum, this we have already discussed. Sorghum bicolor. And Oryza sativa, paddy. Hordeum vulgare. So I'm trying to, you know, move little bit fast here. Hordeum vulgare, because there are so many scientific names that you need to go through. Hordeum vulgare is barley. Triticum isteum, we have already studied, it is wheat, and various other varieties of wheat also we have seen. Yes, sorghum bicolor. This is called as camel of desert because it produces good yields under high temperatures and low soil moisture. And botanical name of sorghum is sorghum bicolor. Origin of sorghum is Africa, belongs to family Gramineae Poaceae. Sorghum is often cross-pollinated crop and is one of the, you know, primarily used human food. Yes. Next comes is botanical name of pineapple. Botanical name of pineapple. Yes, I can see so many correct answers today. Good. Excuse me. Friends, botanical name of pineapple. नो वन और आई एम नॉट गेटिंग आंसर्स हियर, आई मीन लाइव चैट हैज बीन कि यस, सो यस इट इज अनानास कोमसिस, यस अमोल, जितेंद्र, मधुश्री, संगीता, भानुप्रकाश, प्रांजलि, अमीशा, अनुभव, जितेंद्र, सोनाली, पल्लवी, अर्पिता, ब्लैक शैडो, यस ऑल ऑफ यू आर राइट, इट इज अनानास कोमोसिस. व्हाट इज लाइकोपर्सिकॉन एस्कुलेंटम? यस दिस इज टोमेटो. एक्चुअली दिस इज सोलानम लाइकोपर्सिकम, बट द नेम लाइकोपर्सिकॉन एस्कुलेंटम दैट इज गिवन बाय लिनेस, इट हैज बीन यू नो सो पॉपुलर दैट जनरली दिस इज वॉट दैट इज यूज मेनी टाइम्स. अनानास वी हैव सीन, इट्स पाइनएपल. सोनालम सॉरी सोलानम मेलंजिना, यस ब्रिंजॉल एंड कैप्सिकम फ्रूटेंसिस, यस इट इज चिल्ली, वाइल्ड चिल्ली पेपर. सो this and it's a tropical plant with an edible fruit and family bromeliaceae. Can anyone tell me the speciality of pineapple? What is the, you know, the enzyme that it produces? Yes, here Madhushree is too fast here. She gave all the answers even without, you know, asking. Good Madhushree. Yes, friends, what is the enzyme that is produced by this Anana's comosus, which is generally used as a meat tenderizer, or these days it is also used in weight loss programs because, you know, it digests that protein. See, even that's the reason whenever you eat fresh pineapple also, you'll feel that, you know, tinginess on your tongue because it eats that flesh, the tongue also, whatever that flesh is there. Yes, it is bromelain. It is this enzyme because of which, you know, it is used as a meat tenderizer and also in various other weight loss programs. Yes, friends. Okay, this we have just now discussed. Lycopersicon esculentum. It's a botanical name of tomato. Brinjal we have seen. Solanum melangina. Potato, anyone? What is the scientific name of potato? Yes, fruit of Tripura. Okay, friends, potato. Potato, it is Solanum tuberosum. Banana. See, whatever banana we are eating, you know, they come from two major species, Musa acuminata and Musa bulbiciana. So whatever bananas we eat today, you know, they are called as hybrids of Musa acuminata or Musa bulbiciana. Yes, and spinach, Spinacea oleracea, and this again belongs to the family Amaranthaceae. Someone was saying it's Chenopodiaceae. Yes, Amaranthaceae, other name for the same family, it's Chenopodiaceae. Yes, Musa acuminata and Musa bulbiciana, and yes, see again Solanum tuberosum, it belongs to family Solanaceae. Musa, Musaceae. Okay, yes, most of you all are right here. Next, Allium sativum, it is a botanical name of picture here already is shown. It is garlic, and onion, it is Allium sepa. Rubber plant, I have written somewhere. Yes, it is Ficus elastica. Yes, Ficus elastica, it belongs to the family Moraceae, to which fig plant, mulberry plant they belong to. Jute, we have already seen. Mista also we have already seen. This is fig, that is ficus species. So friends, moving on to our last question. Desi chana or desi gram is botanically known as. It is also, you know, robusta bananas, they are, you know, cross or, you know, hybrids of one of these main bananas only. Yes, curious cat, you know, last time also we have seen one or two scientific names they have asked in prelims. This is generally, useful for your prelim phase one exam, where one question it might be asked from scientific names. Yes, there are a lot of jute varieties. Thank you, Pallavi. Yes, it is Sicer arantinum, and this is of two types. Rest all we have already seen. So I am moving on to this. Chickpea, also known as a gram or Bengal gram. Chickpea is the king of pulses, and two types. Desi or kala, or that the brown chickpea which we generally use, Sicer arantinum, and kabuli chana, that is white chickpea, Sicer kabulinum, and origin is from Afghanistan. When we were young, we used to listen to that kabuli wala. This is what that from Afghanistan. Family leguminaceae, subfamily papilionaceae, self-pollinated long day crop, and is considered as dry land crop. And this is the one that is, you know, produced in rabi season. Yes, tossa and white jute, two varieties of jute. So friends, this is all for today. I mean the questions. Moving on to our next section, that is answer to homework question. Yesterday I asked you a question: a biological phenomenon by which an organism produces one or more biochemicals that influence the germination, growth, survival, and reproduction of other organism. What is that phenomenon called? This is called as allelopathy. See, sometimes, no, the few plants, they produce some chemicals that are not suitable. This is the reason one should, the farmer should be, you know, he should take care while going for intercropping. He has to be very careful so that there won't be any allelopathic reaction between those two. For example, in sunflower and groundnut, they can't go for intercropping because sunflower has some allelopathic effect on groundnut. So this is one of the example. And also similar to that, you know, sorghum also, it releases hydrocyanic acid, which is toxic to some types of weeds. So this allelopathy is one important factor that, you know, we need to consider, or the farmer needs to consider while going for a crop, you know, intercropping, etc. Yes, see, a global seed vault is made to preserve a wide variety of plant seeds held in gene banks worldwide. This is an attempt to ensure against the loss of seeds, you know, in case of any global crisis. Where is this located? Yes, eucalyptus is also one best example. It doesn't, you know, allow to thrive other, other plants to thrive. So friends, where is this global seed vault located? And also one seed vault is in India. Also give me those two names. Tomorrow we'll discuss that. So let's see what all questions you have. Anubhav will be having one or two exclusive sessions on, you know, schemes that, you know, Ritika ma'am would be taking very soon. We have already planned. See, Deepak, mulch is something that is generally used, you know, either, you know, in the form of live mulch like cover crops, or dry mulch like straw, hay or something, or even sometimes plastic mulches also. This helps in, you know, retention of soil moisture retention, and also it doesn't allow the weeds to grow. Between the rows of the crop, this is done, mulching is done. Okay, Dhirendra, No, technical vacancy earlier also they had released. It's not first time. What is first time is for AGM, you know, administration post. They have included a papers, you know, one section, agriculture and agriculture economy. Earlier it was not there. So, okay. So friends, how we can help you here? We have already launched the courses for NABARD Grade A 2021, and these are the various packages that or course offerings that we are offering currently. And currently we are offering a 15% flat discount. You can use the code early15 to use to avail this discount, and we are also giving you 30% off for old subscribers as well. So friends, this is all from my end today. Any questions, suggestions, anything, most welcome. Deepika, there is no one site. You have to, you know, go through few sites, and you have to filter out the agriculture related news. Yes, yes, Ashwini, mulching can be done, Cispania, Crotalaria, etc., and also hay. Notification, it should come very soon. Ashwini, पिछली बार नहीं आया था FCA AGM, you know, 2015 में कुछ आया था FCA AGM post. You're most welcome, Madhushree. Actually, Jitendra rating rice crop में नहीं, वो नो even ये AFO में question आया था कि rating है या rating है. लेकिन रेटिंग ऐसे नहीं है कि सिर्फ राइस क्रॉप पे होता है, नहीं, वेरियस क्रॉप्स में होता है. वो एक जो मैंने पढ़ा है एक बुक से, उसमें नॉट इवन बुक, इट वाज एन आर्टिकल एक्चुअली. तो उसमें ये दिया था कि द रेटिंग द रेट्स दैट आर प्रोवाइडेड टू वेरियस वेराइटीज ऑफ राइस और द यू नो बेस्ड ऑन द क्वालिटी. लेकिन ऐसा कोई वो टेक्निकल टर्म है या ऑपरेशन यू नो डन इन एनी क्रॉप, ये मैंने कहीं नहीं देखा है. भानु प्रकाश, जनरली नाबार्ड एग्रीकल्चर में न्यूमेरिकल्स नहीं आते हैं. देयर नो न्यूमेरिकल क्वेश्चंस आस्क्ड एज सच. दीपिका, दिस यू हैव टू गो थ्रू पीआईबी एंड देन समटाइम्स आईसीएआर एंड एटलीस्ट वन और टू न्यूज़पेपर्स वेयर यू हैव टू फिल्टर आउट द न्यूज, एग्रीकल्चर न्यूज. यू आर मोस्ट वेलकम, अमीशा. Sonali, as such humne scientific names we haven't provided in any chapter, but yes, in each and every chapter wherever we have come across some crop plants or you know the crops or anything, vegetables, fruits, I have provided the scientific names in bracket there then and there itself. Dhirendra, even I have to check. I think that has come, but okay, if you are saying so confidently, might be technical post haven't come earlier. I have to check once. So friends, any other questions, suggestions? Okay, no questions. Okay friends, thank you very much for your patient listening. And then if you have any doubts regarding the course or course offerings or related to NABARD exam, you know, anything, you can always write to us at hello@edutab.co.in, or you can always contact us on this number. So friends, thank you very much once again. Meet you tomorrow, same time, 9 o'clock. And Dhirendra, I'm asking for previous year question paper technical AGM FCII. Okay. Dhirendra, I have to check. I haven't checked for technical. But yes, you know, admin post, since we have launched a course, I have worked on that. I'll answer, you know, your query tomorrow. Black Shadow, already I have asked you today's question. This is our today's questions global seed vault. Deepak, yes, for soil science, for AGM post, administration post, you can go through the soils, the erosion part, classification of soils, and the nutrition part. All that are important. Hope, Deepak, I was able to answer your question. You're most welcome, Jitendra. The news of wild marigold.